It's good to be a villain all the time.
Bluefield, if the Doctor is not returned, we cannot create your movie. Let's get to work now.
Oh, bloody hell. What the... Mr. Bond. Looks like there's a big maximum entrance.
I don't know what you're talking about. That Dalek just slid down the stairs.
Boo, I knew you were coming. I've been expecting you. Dr. Lee Eglin Bond.
Oh, crap.
Oh, so you're the one who took my remote? So why, Blue, huh? Mr. Bluefield, huh? Why are you trying to take my remote? Oh, sorry, one seat. Can't sit there.
Yes, that's true, because you tracked me down and I tracked you down. Yes, this is my evil plan. Anyway, back to the plan. Okay, don't be naughty. I stole the remote from you, so I can buy all of the Jurassic World DVDs. I mean, two of them. Well, only two of them coming out. But then once I have all two of them, I'll keep the remote for the rest of my life to make you with me, Doctor Who.
What? You want to watch the full Jurassic World with the sky remote? Can you just buy on eBay or Amazon like everybody else?
Well, you see, I accidentally ran out my account from Amazon, and also I forgot my account from eBay, so.
More than you win it, Blue. You're gonna get me that remote. You're probably the worst villain that ever created in my channel.
You're so with the bossy than Gordon Ramsay. 007, how are you gonna stop me, huh? Without this remote, you can't have a living.
Easy. If this is a James Bond two-part filler, I'm gonna use my knockout dart pen.
Gotcha.
Right, give me that.
Wait, where's the remote? Yeah, 007.
Ooh, that gave me way. Can now get me away from Bluefield.
Right, okay. Let's pull the emergency brakes. Right, put the radio on.
It's your movies, baby. I know you found them to see you. You think you're gonna
do me that easy? Hey! Look, that's from John Percy.
Doesn't even hurt! No!
Well, he might be fine. Well, maybe. Oh, I got the remote. Anyway, welcome to season 12 review, episode 2 of Doctor Who of the season 12. Let's do this. Welcome to the episode 2 of the season 12 review. Anyway, I just do that because to show you what episode we are on to. Anyway, now, so yeah, welcome.
Welcome to the season overview, and today I'm reviewing the last week's episode, yesterday's episode. On Sunday's episode of Doctor Who called Spyfall Part 2. Yes, the second part of the Spyfall, James Bond thriller. Yeah. And if you have watched my other last review, and I comment in and say I like the weapons of the Master. Yeah, thank you. Keep commenting. So let's go to the episode. Five actors. I will be reviewing, and also the big Marjol, big shocking thriller. What happened in the ending, and including the area of the episode and the return of, oh my god, something really has come back in the season, and including the monsters in the episode. So let's go to the characters.
So the character we'll review is Mr. Martin, who is played as Leonard Henry. So what do you feel about Leonard Henry in this episode? See, in the episode he's kind of a bit like a villain, so I like him being in the episode. And then when the whole episode is more like James Bond now. Well, not James Bond, because it was in the first part it looked like James Bond, and then in the second part it kind of like Doctor Who now, and he got similar to John Sims' master. I'm not saying there are two masters. He's still a villain in the episode. Working the master. But I just want to say, he played a brilliant cast in the episode. Great work, Leonard Henry. And the next actor we're talking about is a history character, because in the episode the Doctor did travel in the 1940s in Paris, in what you saw in the trailer. It's Arana Marianne who plays Noyant. Yeah, that's her name. See, I heard rumors about that character. See, he's a character who plays a history girl from a woman who plays a British spy who's sent in Paris, that she became the greatest spy, and then sent undercover from Paris. And then in back in 1943, it's 1943, this character was kind of a bit clever, but doing using 1943. I mean, we haven't seen a World War II episode since not in the Demons of Punjab, but since the Christmas special 2017, that was World War One with Capaldi. But in the original with the World War Two, we haven't seen a World War Two episode since the Christmas special with Matt Smith called the Doctor, the Widow, and the Wardrobe. That was my least favorite Christmas special. But anyway, she played a very good spy. Let's work. Keep killing the Nazis. The next actor we're talking about is Sylvia Briggs, who plays Ada Loveless. Yes, she is a lazy history girl as well. She's a girl that can go to sleep and memorize and go some other places, like memorize that people's thoughts. I mean, yeah, people's thoughts. He's like, I read about her from a book I wrote from the 11 Doctors era. But anyway, she looks kind of good in the episode. Since the episode, I thought she became a companion, but no, they just said that they have to keep Bradley Walsh, Tosin Ghul, and Yasmin and Jodie Whittaker just play this, because the companions are just only four companions on season 12. Because I thought she was going to be a companion, but me and Lissy did, my sister. But yeah, well, she played a good role. I thought she was like a companion, but learn some knowledge. But anyway, keep sleeping.
The chase is on.
So, yes, Bradley Walsh. Yeah, he was good now in the second part, because he did a funny thing about James Bond again. Yeah, because everyone thinks he was going to be like a James Bond, but no, he's not going to be like Daniel Craig. I don't think so. But anyway, he was a funny like that. Well, he's like Wilford Mott from David Tennant's era. Well, anyway, nice work, Bradley. You really kicked off the master from his episode. And so the most important character we need to talk about is the Master. Yes, the Master. The Master is back now in the season. In the season, who is played is Chateau Doan. Chateau Doan is played as the Master. So, what about the Master now in the second part of this episode? See, I hate to say this, he's kind of like a bit. He's very hatred and kind of got over so excited and got overreacted. Because he's kind of bit be overreacted and killing all the stuff. I mean, that's why the Master does. I mean, he has to be feared. I mean, people will need to fear that. It's like Kylo Ren.
You know what he did since the end of the episode. He told the Doctor that he went back to Gallifrey. Gallifrey has returned in the season. Yeah, the Doctor went back to Gallifrey, and when he's pushed off into the time vortex, he went outside the universe. I thought the whole lightning effect of the editing was just like the Gallifrey was obliterated. But no, he went outside the universe. Maybe it's like the void. Yeah, because. Because remember from Doomsday, when the Doctor lost Rose, when he was outside at the universe and he saw the void between time from the universe itself. So yeah, that's where he went back. He went outside of the universe. That's where Gallifrey was. Because ever since season 9, they said they found Gallifrey at the end of the universe was around season 9, but. But now it's outside the universe, because now it's, well, I hate to say, because it's being destroyed by the Master. The Master, yes. Well, now that Gallifrey's destroyed, it's like coming back to the Russell T. Davis era. I mean, Russell T. Davis, everyone was so shocked about the Doctor, thinking what happened to Gallifrey back from the Time War, and yeah, it went back from the day of the Doctor for the 50th anniversary special. So yeah, it could be shocking that Gallifrey is gone. I mean, not just the planet, but the Citadel. The Citadel, yeah. So why did the Master destroy Gallifrey? Because he discovered something. Something that the Time Lords had done, or where they kept a secret from the Doctor and the Master. Something about the Timeless Child.
What is the timeless child?
I mean, it could be something that the Time Lords have done, or maybe something happened from the beginning of the Time Lords, about the Founding Fathers. I mean, the Master is about something about the Founding Fathers of Gallifrey, including a big montage about the Doctor. I mean. He told them about their true identity. I mean, something at the Time Lords that they keep a secret about their true identity, the Doctor and the Master in their true identity. I mean, are the Master and the Doctor are not Time Lords? I mean, I can't believe it. I mean, I'm so shocked about. I'm gonna think about this everything about the episode. I mean, what happened now? I mean, it's. I mean, what. I mean, what the heck? I mean, the Doctor is a Time Lord. I mean, how could he regenerate? I mean, did this timeless child give the energy or something that made them regenerate? I mean, to turn all these Time Lords to Time Lords? I mean, what timeless child was not a Time Lord, or was he a Time Lord? I mean, yeah, I mean, I thought back in season 11 when they mentioned the timeless child, they said that the timeless child was the Master, or could be. Or could it be about Susan Foreman? It can't be Susan, because I don't think Susan Dr. Grantle's not coming back this season. I mean, if Chipner revealed that, it actually nothing to the child. I mean, Gallifrey destroyed. The Master revealed that the Doctor was not a Time Lord and the Timeless Child. I mean, can this reveal what has been happening? This Chipnall has run doing his own episode. I mean, did the Russell the Davis? Yeah, Russell the Davis must have get that idea from Chipnall. So, yeah, I'm just a. Sorry. I need to calm down. So, it's kind of mean mind that, well, we have to wait for the rest of the season until they make sure we can reel. And maybe because the plan for the next season, season 13, and I think that I may have a big plan, it will change everything in the season. Yeah, because that's not the end for Gallifrey, I think, because we see the new Gallifrey. I mean, maybe they might go rebuild it somehow. I mean, maybe survivors cut off from Gallifrey before the Master destroyed it. But anyway, what's gone to the errors of the episode?
And what I thought about Geordi Whittaker in the second part with first him with the Master? Yeah, it was kind like back in the classic Who's, because with the Master, as maybe you saw the bit of the trailer for the second part that he did the knocks. Yeah, that's the Nox. Anyway, so it was kind of good with him and the master, but and then once in the ending, when he found out whether the Gallifrey was destroyed and then he figured she wasn't a Time Lord. But yeah, it's a mysterious thing that's been happening around the season. And maybe after the season, I'm afraid there's something about to change. So we'll see what we find out. But anyway, Geordi Whittaker, nice work, and great work to beat the Master. But at your first time with him.
The errors of the episode. So what the fuck about the Gallifrey? See, it was kind of good. I mean, Gallifrey was what rippled and then destroyed and blown up and all the Citadel. I mean, it's like I watched this something on YouTube called something about WHO S12 and. But anyway, they did a big part of the Gallifrey was destroyed, and then it's come back like Russell T. Davis there, that the Doctor thinks that the Gallifrey was destroyed, and then since the day of the Doctor, it wasn't. So it's kind of completely destroyed. The Doctor's going to be angry for the Master, because I don't think the Master is not dead yet. I mean, not gone. He might come back in the season. Yeah, he has to come back. I mean, Sakadora plays a little better than the Master. I mean, he's kind of hatred. So yeah, and all this new Jane and the errors about the trailer about the world, well, World War II. Yeah, they went back in World War II on 1943. I mean, good location, good point about World War II. Yeah, kind of. For Paris, yeah, that's good, and including Victorian times. I thought they went back for World War II first. I like the idea. I mean, going back is like because I don't. That's why they put the Master in, and it's TARDIS and the shrinking people. I mean, yeah, it's all going back like John Pertwee's era. Yeah, I like it. So let's go now. Next, we're going to do the monsters in the episode.
Yeah, some of these bright monsters in the episode. So we learned about the name, but I can't spoil their names. But what I thought about them? See, we learn about their knowledge, and the Doctor mentioned about the first part. Yeah, and when I learned about that, it's kind of like it's these monsters are due about some about time travel again, because the seasons keep pushing up about time travel. I mean, first them in the Demon of the Pond job, but we know about these monsters from the Derby Pond job, where we're just celebrating the people about when they're about to die, and those people those people who work for the far future from Twice Upon a Time with Peter Capaldi, his last episode again, and they're these monsters are full of, I mean, and they're bright up, and then Bradley done something to them, and yeah, that's good. Anyway, I can't say much more about these monsters, but anyway, thanks. Anyway, good monsters, and I hope I see more.
So that's all for this episode now. If you guys want to comment down below what you thought to the episode about this shocking ending, and if you want information about the Timeless Child, just comment below and put a like and subscribe.
I need more subscribers!
Oh, because if you want to share this video on Facebook or Instagram or TikTok, whatever, just anything, just share this video and give. and give many support of me. So and give more subscribers. So thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you next time in another video. Next week with you, it will be called Orphan 55. I think the episode's called that, but I don't know what's about this episode, but I'll see you next time. Tally-o!